cheat engine can edit almost anything in games. The way this works is that data is stored by values, by ints, doubles, floats, strings. That's how they're edited. And cheat engine goes in and edits those values, lets you edit them. Now, how do you use cheat engine? Well, that's what I'll teach you today, and I'll actually give you a demonstration on me actually using it in Adventure Capitalist, the game, so I hope you guys enjoy. Cool, now that we have Cheat Engine open, it'll give us a tutorial so we can learn what it is. Has a password, just click OK. Cool, the first thing it wants us to do is change this health to 100 by using the engine. So we can see that's 100 and we click hit me. It's now at 95. So what we can do is open this up on the tutorial. Find 95 for the value, 95 exact value type. We'll just pick on all because we don't know what this health bar actually is. So we can set that and click on first scan. Now we have a few of these, and what we want to do, click on hit me, and this changed to red, dude. It's the only one that changed. Value is 91, health is 91. We can double click on it, and if we click on hit me, it changes with the health. We want to change it to 1000, so we can double click on value, change it to 1000, and click on OK. Now if we click on hit me again, it exactly the same. Now this next button will show up. So now what this next one wants us to do is figure out a number. It's an unknown number between 0 and 500. Alright, so we want to do smaller than 501 because it's in between 0 and 500 and new scan, first scan. There we go. Now it popped up with 1.3 million. You can scan that down, but unchanged value, just click on next scan. Now it's not changing by much. So now what we want to do is click on hit me minus 8. Awesome. Now we can do decreased value. Click on next scan, and if it decreases, it will take this down to 4000. Hit me again, minus 9. Hit again. We're at 92 now. And we can continuously do this until we find the number we are looking for. Now we're at this is now we're at this. This is the only one with the single digit, so I think it might be that. I'll double click on this. Take this old one. I'll actually delete it. Now with the 336, if we click hit me, minus 6, it decreases by 6. And the minus 9 decreases by 9. We want that at 5,000, so we double click, type in 5,000. Okay, and then this next button pops up, and if we click hit me, minus 8, and it decreases by 8. Now we can click on next. Cool. Now we have different things. We want to set them both to 5,000 or higher. Alright, cool. We can do that. The health is a float. Now that we know it's a float, we can actually click on new scan, all, and then float at 100 for the exact value. Exact value is 100 for the float. New scan. First one is at 100. If we click on hit me, it decreases just with the health. So let's remove this. Double click. And then we want it at 5,000. Okay. And then the ammo is a double. So new scan. Double. That one's at 100. First scan. It's just this one. If we click on fire, 99.5. That's the same. We'll send that to 5,000. Okay. And then this next button. Awesome. Now we have Adventure Capitalist up with the cheat engine. So let's pick the Adventure Capitalist open, and we have no money currently on here. So what we can do is go to all of them. Exact value will be 0. First scan, and it'll scan through all of them because we have nothing, obviously. Cool. Now it came up with 123 million. Now we can do unchanged values next scan, and it will, okay, well, it's It's busy scanning, so let's give it a second. Awesome, cool, now it's done scanning. I'll do next scan again and let it just go through. And it looks like it's kind of stuck at the same thing. So now we can do increased value and just click on here. And now we have 46 off tilling. Cool, increased value, next scan. And it decreased it under a million. Cool, now we'll increase the money again. And just continuously do this. Next scan. Up. Next scan. Now we're down to 2,000. Alright, now we're down to almost only 900. And 778. Cool, now it's kind of just slowing down. So we'll just do decrease value and just start buying up stuff. So let's do the maximum. Cool, there we go. And then next scan. We're down to only 150 of these. Now it looks like some of these values might be changing. So let's do unchanged values. Next scan, 67 found. Awesome. Can we do it again? 61 found. Cool, it looks like that one's changing a little bit. So let's do it again, 60. Awesome. Now let's do decrease value again and just continuously do this until we have an idea on how much we have. We have 54, 52, next scan. Now we stuck at 52, our increased value, and let's just increase our value, and next scan. We're at about 52 now, so we have enough where we can actually scroll through this and see what we have. So what we want to do is we have 288. We see 288 right here, 288 right here. So we can continuously pick these ones with the 288. Awesome. Now that we have them all picked out, we can click on here and it'll bring all of the doubles that we have. So it's a type double. So we have all of them down here and we can edit. So if we actually take this and buy one, we can see all of them will change. Perfect. All right. So now we can see we have the oil company at a couple quadrillion. So if we change this to zero, when copy and paste this, alright, it does not change. There we are, perfect, boom. So we change that and this stops. So if we change this up to like 200 million, okay. Boom, it shows up again, cool. Now we can delete the rest that we know it's not these ones and just start editing this. How much money we technically have. Delete and delete. Oh, whoops. Delete, delete, delete. Cool. And now we're stuck with this double. Well, we're not stuck with the double, but we found how much money we technically have. We found the value that determines how much money we have. So now we can go over here and just start kind of messing with it. Let me just buy out everything. And then just start messing around with it. Actually, let's do this a few times until this says E108. Awesome. Now we'll change that to E1000. Okay. Boom. Maximum. I think we broke the game maybe. Oh no, we just changed it to infinity. Damn. 1E23. Okay, cool. We're now back up. Let's just change that to maybe 123. Awesome. Boop. And there we go. So now we can actually, let's buy all of these. And perfectly, we got the 6 trillion. Let's take this E, change this back. Can we do 900? We can do 900. Nope, that just changes to infinity plus. Damn. 1E500. And you kind of just edit this until you figure out what it is. 1E125. It seems like 125 might be the highest. And then we can just work on this and edit it until you figure out what the max is. E200. Maybe E250. E250 works. E300, and then we'll just continuously do this until we find the max. E350. 349. Okay, well. 301. 301. Alright, I'll stick with this. Now we got like the maximum we can have. Upgrades. Let's just buy out all the angels. Now they're all kind of just going quickly. And upgrades. Quick buy. Quick buy. Perfect. 6 trillion. We still have that. 6,000 we can buy. So let's just do that. How far can we max out this game stats? Alright, let's just... 301. Let's copy that. 10, 13. And let's... 10,000. We got 10,000 of them. Let's do that again. Well, because we already have the value, we can just... let's do next. One. What's the maximum on some... Oh! 10,000 is the maximum. Maybe? I don't know. We've basically maxed out the game.